My secret origin is fairly simple. I grew up being not a fan of comic books, but of cartoons. I was first exposed to superheroes through TV shows like The Super Friends, and later live action shows like The Incredible Hulk and the Wonder Woman TV series. I actually wanted to go into museum exhibition and design, and still one day, I think I have a dream of somehow working in, managing and designing museum exhibitions. I love that stuff. Around junior high school, I believe it was, a couple of friends introduced to me superhero comics. I had read Star Wars, the comic, the Marvel comic that Walter Simonson drew based on the films, so I knew the medium, but I didn't read superhero stuff until my friends introduced them to me in junior high school. It was X-Men and New Teen Titans and all that great stuff that was coming out in the early 80s. It sort of changed the industry and still lingers today. I thought it was magical. I'd never seen anything like it. Friends asked me to copy imagery from those books, which I did. I started making my own comics featuring really, really obvious copies of like the X-Men, turning my friends into characters, etc. So by the time high school ended, I think I'd created over 50 comic books. Realizing that I desperately wanted to leave my hometown and I was raised in Southern California, I found the School of Visual Arts in New York City, and they had a cartooning illustration program, and I decided I was going to draw comic books. And so I moved to New York City. I began attending SVA in its illustration and cartooning department. I vigorously pursued editors at DC Comics in the meantime, and I built a portfolio over about 2 years. I was rejected a couple of times, and then finally, as I say, after my sophomore year, I submitted my portfolio and was hired, and then I got those War of the Gods pages. So at some point early in this decision-making process where I thought I'm going to become a comic book artist, I realized very quickly that the people that could give me jobs were not artists and writers, but editors. So by 16 or 17, I wasn't trying to meet my favorite creators at comic conventions. I was trying to meet editors. I also happened to realize that my favorite books at the time were almost all edited by one person, who was Karen Berger. So at every convention I could find her, "Hi Karen, I love your stuff, I want to work for you." When I moved to New York and I was attending school, I did a sort of side job for, an independent book that was never published, but I got 15 pages out of it. This was enough to sort of create a portfolio. Also, when I moved to New York, I called Karen Berger, and in a story where she says to this day she doesn't know why she picked up the phone or said yes, I asked if I could come meet her. She said yes. I showed her my work. She's like, "You're not good enough. Take this script. Come back in 6 months." Literally, I went home. I went to the calendar. I counted out 6 months to the day, wrote "Call Karen Berger." In that 6 months, I drew those pages at the same time I was doing my college work, called her up 6 months later, "Hey, can I come visit you?" "Yes." And so for me, I didn't do a lot of schlepping when it came to portfolio. I was really focused and specific. I knew who I wanted to work for. I knew what title I wanted to work on. So for me, it was all about making my work desirable and accessible to this one woman for this one job. I'm not sure I would recommend that now. I definitely think you don't want to spread yourself too thin. I don't think you want a portfolio with 9 different ways of working or that's going to appeal to 9 different people. I believe just for focus reasons, it's better to create a portfolio that has, you know, maybe 2 or 3 really strong sets of samples, or that we might, that, you know, targeting a couple of different people. But for me, it was all about this. It was so strategic. It was all about, I'm going to work for this person. It was the only way I could focus. Because I find otherwise, I can't focus at all. If I can't focus on one thing, then I'm focused on 1,000, and I get nothing done.